The virgin will be with child and will give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. Well, a very, very happy Christmas to you all, and a very warm welcome to you for our online service from St. Andrew's and St. Bede's. My name is the Reverend Dan Connolly. I'm a retired clergyman worshipping in St. Andrew's. These are unusual times, aren't they, as we continue to struggle with the ever-changing scene of and the effects of COVID-19 and the very many changes that this has been bringing our way. But what has not changed, friends, is that the Lord Jesus came to be our Saviour. And he, of course, is Emmanuel, God with us. And he brings God's light and his love into our lives today and every day. And so we continue our worship with the hymn, Once in Royal David's City. And as we rejoice in our Saviour on this very special day, so now we call to mind our failings and we pause to confess our sins. Lord of grace and truth, We confess our unworthiness to stand in your presence as your children. For we have sinned. Forgive and heal us. The Virgin Mary accepted your call to be the mother of Jesus. Please forgive our disobedience to your will. For we have sinned. Forgive and heal us. Your Son, our Saviour, was born in poverty in a manger. So please forgive our greed and rejection of your ways. We have sinned. Forgive and heal us. The shepherds left their flocks to go to Bethlehem. Please forgive our self-interest and lack of vision. We have sinned. Forgive and heal us. The wise men followed the star to find Jesus the King. Forgive our reluctance to seek you. We have sinned. Forgive and heal us. Friends, may God, who loved the world so much that he sent his Son to be our Saviour, forgive us our sins and make us holy to serve him in the world through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And now our worship continues with the beautiful carol, Hark the Herald Angels Sing. There are some wonderful truths contained here that we need to take hold of today. Among them, a great reminder of God and man being reconciled. Hark the herald angels sing.
Thank you.
Our worship continues with the collect, which speaks of heaven touching earth. Lord Jesus Christ, your birth at Bethlehem draws us to kneel in wonder at heaven touching earth. Accept our heartfelt praise as we worship you, our Saviour and our eternal God. Amen. We continue with the Gospel reading.
Alleluia, alleluia. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we have seen his glory. Alleluia. John 1, verses 1 to 14. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, but the darkness has not understood it. There came a man who was sent from God. His name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so that through him all men might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light. The true light that gives light to every man was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who received him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. Children born not of natural descent, nor of human decision or a husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ. Well, in many ways, this time of COVID-19 has made us feel a bit isolated and perhaps greatly missing friends and family. It's been terribly hard, I think, for so many folk, but I guess all of us look forward to breaking free again. And we hear talk, don't we, of the triumph which has been brought through the breakthrough of a number of antivirus treatments for which we're all immensely grateful. And this year has also demonstrated that we can get connected in ways that we had not realised before. So Christmas letters that Val and I have received have spoken of hitherto quite untechnical people managing to master the arts of Zoom and FaceTime and Skype and the like. And whilst it's not the same at all, for me, seeing my grandchildren's face on a screen, if not actually in the flesh, helps me somehow to feel connected again. No, it's not the same, but it is a great help. And of course, in our online service this morning, we are doing just that. Connecting electronically through a screen. Connection is important. However, connection is being achieved. But what has that got to do with Christmas? Well, Christmas is really all about God connecting. You see, in the birth of Jesus, God connects with his people in a powerful way, beginning the process of restoring our broken relationship with him. It was almost 400 years ago that the great reformer Martin Luther wrote these words. Not a soul notices, not a soul understands what God is doing in the stable. He leaves empty the palaces and stately homes. He leaves the masses to their eating and drinking and good cheer. Consequently, the comfort and treasure in Christ remains hidden. Oh, what a thick black darkness hung over Bethlehem that night when she failed to apprehend so great a light within her walls. The event of the first Christmas is about God connecting with you and me in a really powerful way. A baby was born in a stable who was no ordinary child. This is Jesus, who is the Son of God. Yet most of the people in Bethlehem at the time will not have noticed anything. And Luther's comment 400 years ago rings so true. Oh, what a thick black darkness hung over Bethlehem that night when she failed to apprehend so great a light within her walls. And sadly, people still miss the point today. A lot has been said in recent weeks about how very important Christmas is, but hardly ever has the real reason which makes it special been mentioned. Luther understood what God was doing in the stable. God was connecting with us. And we read earlier from John's Gospel those very well-known words, to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God. Friends, this is God's great gift to us. And of course, one of the names given to Jesus is Emmanuel, God with us. In Jesus, despite our failures and unworthiness, God reconnects with us. Jesus gave his life to restore our relationship, to cleanse us, and to make us new. So as we trust in Jesus today, God is close. Friends, Luther knew the power of God breaking into the world in the birth of Jesus in the stable. May we all know God connecting with us today, and the joy, comfort, and reassurance that this brings. And on this great day, I want to give St. Paul the last word. Thanks be to God for his indescribable gift. Amen. And now on this wonderful Christmas day, we make our profession of faith, joining in our creed together. We believe and trust in God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We believe in God the Father, the Master of creation, who made us for himself. We believe in Jesus. Jesus, the Son of God, who is seated at the Father's right hand, who gave himself for us, who triumphed over sin and death, and who reassures us of God's love. And we believe in the Holy Spirit, who breathes life into our being each day, and who works to make us more like Jesus. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We continue together now in a time of prayer, and Val will lead our prayers for us.
To us a child is born, to us a son is given. Let us pray for the people he came to save. Wonderful Counselor, you order all things with your wisdom. Help the Church to reveal the mystery of your love and fill her with the Spirit of Truth. To us a child is born,
to us a son is given.
Mighty God, the government is on your shoulders. So guide the leaders of the nations and bring in your kingdom of justice and righteousness. To us a child is born.
To us a son is given.
Everlasting Father, you call us to live together in unity. Protect by your mercy all your children. Bless our families and renew our communities. To us a child is born.
To us a son is given.
Merciful Father, accept
these prayers
through
your Son, our Saviour,
Jesus
Christ.
Amen.
We join together singing the hymn, O Come, All Ye Faithful.
Join with us.
As we close, we turn our thoughts to our world and to all those around us. So let us pray together. Father God, you sent your Son to redeem us and to bring light into darkness. Shine among us today. Be close to those finding life difficult. Be near all who are lonely, isolated, or afraid. Shine among us today. Guide all who lead and make decisions that affect others. Shine among us today. Comfort those who mourn with the hope of resurrection. Shine among us today. And now, together, we receive God's blessing. Christ, who by his incarnation gathered into one things earthly and heavenly, fill you with peace and goodwill, and make you partakers of the divine nature. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.